On today's episode of Answer This, we're going to be talking about one of the most common viruses passed from mother to infant during pregnancy that could have serious implications if left untreated. It's the first in our three-episode series of Answer This, sponsored by Moderna, that will be taking a close look at health equity for women, especially new mothers. Welcome to Answer This. I'm Zinclay Essamoua. Cytomegalovirus, or CMV, is commonly found in adults. More than half of all Americans will have the virus by the age of 40, according to the CDC. But babies born with congenital CMV infection can have serious side effects that will present long-term health problems. Today, I'm joined by Dr. Gail Demmler-Harrison, an infectious disease expert at Texas Children's Hospital, whose research focuses on CMV in newborns. Thank you for being here.
Thanks so much for inviting me to talk about CMV. It's a very important topic.
Of course, it's important. And I want to start just plainly with a simple question, and that is, could you explain to us and our viewers what CMV is?
CMV is cytomegalovirus. It's probably the most common virus most people have never heard of. It's a common DNA virus. Most of us will be infected with it sometime in our life.
Thank you. And who is most at risk for CMV?
Well, actually, everybody can acquire CMV. About 1 out of 200 babies are born with CMV. That's called congenital CMV infection. Toddlers are virtual hot zones for CMV. They pass it very frequently between themselves in daycare centers and group settings and home care settings. Adolescents are another sort of hot zone of CMV transmission. And then finally, women of childbearing age, especially if they're pregnant, can also catch CMV, and that can actually have serious consequences to their pregnancy and to their unborn child.
And you mentioned this is very common. We know that the CDC says 1 out of every 200 babies is born with congenital CMV infection. But what are the most common side effects you see? If you could break that down, especially for viewers who may not be familiar.
Well, CMV most of the time in adults, toddlers, and even newborns has absolutely no symptoms at all. And the newborns that have congenital CMV, about 90% or so may be asymptomatic, that is, have no symptoms at all. You cannot pick them out of the normal newborn nursery. Yet about 20% of them will go on to have a progressive hearing loss. Babies who do have symptoms of CMV at birth can have a wide variety of symptoms. They may be as subtle as some petechiae or little blood spots on their skin, a small rash, enlarged liver or spleen. Sometimes they can have abnormalities of their liver enzymes or low platelets in their blood count. Sometimes, unfortunately, the virus can affect the baby's brain. They can be born with what's called microcephaly or a small head, or their brain can be malformed or can have calcifications or cystic malformations. And then finally, CMV can also affect the sensory organs. It can cause vision loss and blindness. And its most common sequelae or side effect in the newborn is hearing loss, either one-sided or two-sided hearing loss that is often progressive in nature.
And how long does it take for these symptoms to present? As you mentioned, some newborns can be asymptomatic and adults, and others present these symptoms. How long can it take to see or know?
Well, in the newborn, sometimes the hearing loss is present at birth and can be picked up through routine newborn hearing screening. And then targeted testing for CMV in those babies who do refer on their newborn hearing screen. But the sort of the sneaky part of congenital CMV-associated hearing loss is that it is often later in onset, and it can present as late as 1 month of age or many years of age.
And obviously, hearing loss is a serious side effect, especially for newborns, knowing how much language development happens when a child is born and in their first few months, and it can get progressively worse after a baby is born. So what can be done to treat it?
So that's a very good question. The first thing is to detect it, because a child doesn't know hearing loss is occurring if it's not detected. So that's the first sort of step in doing something, is knowing that they're at risk and detecting it early. There are antivirals that have been shown in randomized clinical trials to reduce the effects of the hearing loss. It can reduce the progression of the hearing loss, and it can reduce the risk of later onset hearing loss. So there's a medicine that can be given, And it is most effective if it's given in the first month of life and given for 6 months. So that's one thing. But there's other things besides antiviral medicines. After early detection, there is technology that can help the children hear with hearing aids, or in severe, profound hearing loss that is irreversible and not help with hearing aids, cochlear implant technology is amazing. And then there's also other functional therapies, speech language therapies, auditory therapies, and as well as ASL sign language, as well as other speech language therapies.
And I do wonder what you hear from new mothers and parents who encounter CMV in their newborns, either in themselves or in their children, especially given how much goes undetected. What do you hear from these families?
Well, I run a very busy congenital CMV clinic here in Houston. And what surprises me the most, and also tugs at my heart, is that as they hold their baby with congenital CMV, they look at me and said, why did those that came before me not warn me? Why didn't I know about this very common virus? All I had to do is Google search CMV, and a wealth of information cascades. So that's the thing that affects me the most, is that they didn't know about CMV before their baby was born. And didn't know about some potential things they could do to maybe reduce their risk.
And in that vein, are there precautions that expecting mothers can and should take?
Yes, there are. Many CMV experts think that women of childbearing age should know about CMV. And I call it the CMV knowledge vaccine, or information immunization, an ounce of CMV awareness. You have to first know CMV exists. And three simple precautions that you can take. First, don't eat or drink after your young toddler or preschooler in your home, knowing that they might be hot zones for CMV and have CMV in their saliva. Second, wash your hands carefully after changing diapers of your toddler and your infant, even wet diapers, not just poopy diapers, but wet diapers, because CMV is in urine. Third, avoid kissing your baby on or around the lips and on the face while you're pregnant. Give them a big hug or kiss them on top of the head instead while you're pregnant. Those three simple precautions, combined with an ounce of awareness that CMV exists, will reduce their risk. Nothing is 100%, but it will reduce their risk of acquiring CMV while they're pregnant.
And why do you think, with CMV specifically, there is not as much awareness for adults, new mothers, families?
That is a very good question. I've been doing this for over 30 years, and literally shouting from the rooftops about CMV. And I don't know why there's not more CMV awareness. Many things get a lot more attention than CMV. I think some of the reason maybe is we are a reactive society instead of a proactive society. CMV is stealth. It's quiet, it's always there, and it's not something new. I think if headlines came out that 30,000 babies each year in this country have been born with a virus that could cause hearing loss and developmental disabilities, it might get everybody's attention.
Well, it's clear that you have been doing and will continue to do powerful work. Dr. Gail Demmler-Harrison, thank you for being here.
Thank you for inviting me to talk about CMV and spreading CMV awareness.
Of course, and thank you to everyone for watching Answer This. I'm Zinclay Asamoah.